to our nation, those who have served and those who continue to serve, we invite you to please rise and join the band in the singing of God Bless America. Since its release, this song has been included on countless Best of the 80s compilations and sold millions of copies. Enjoy our high-energy tribute to Blondie's iconic Call Me.
Thank you.
has enjoyed a recent resurgence, inspired by photographs and documentaries. The rock band Toto wrote and recorded this song in 1982. Ladies and gentlemen, the Marching Eagles are proud to present one of the top songs of the 80s. This is Africa. As their new name, they began writing new music, and one of their new songs catapulted to the top of the charts all around the world. Enjoy one of 1985's favorite songs, We Built This City. Recognizable song to come out of the 80s. It's a staple of karaoke nights everywhere and has been covered by groups in every genre imaginable. The lyrics were inspired by keyboardist Jonathan Cain, whose father used to tell him, "Don't stop believing or you're done, dude." Sit back and enjoy Journey's legendary chart topper and showstopper, "Don't Stop Believing."
Thank you.
second show of the season was a one-week show and featured an eclectic mix of contagiously elating and infectiously catchy music. We highlight music from British rocker Muse. This single from their album Resistance was a top 10 song in 7 different countries, and eventually became Muse's best-selling single ever. This is Uprising.
Was here, and then Julia saw what was going on and was like, hey, I'd like to do that. And then jumped in as a freshman to learn how to twirl. To be able to do this, it's a lot. And she's good at it. And so, thank you. And Kyle, who is Shaylin's little brother, obviously, they just like throwing things in their family. And it wasn't last year, the first time that we had you up juggling with the band. And just been a blast to watch. And it just adds that extra little bit to all of our performances that makes it entertaining for everybody to watch. So a big hand for both of these guys.
We now transport you to the streets of South Beach. This Latin dance hit from 2014 will light the roof on fire. The Marching Eagles also feature the juggling talents of senior Kyle Albrecht tonight. We're taking it down, we're bringing it back. Dolly, this is Fireball.
We'll be right back.
far from home just to realize how precious home is. In the mid-1800s, P.T. Barnum gained worldwide fame for his New York Museum, which was filled with live entertainment and exotic animals, drawing hundreds of thousands of visitors each year. Barnum's story was told in the blockbuster 2017 film, The Greatest Showman. Arranged by our own Allison Lively, the Marching Eagles proudly present the opening number from the film, The Greatest Show.
Thank you.
Drumline.
I love you guys.
We continue with our traditional music and a trip of cheers that are always favored at the student section. Let's Go Blue, Dudley Do Right, and William Tell. This is part of last year's Bandcamp show. Let us put a spell on you with our high-energy opener, Runaway Baby.
Thank you.
winning hit from summer 2014. Dylan Bosch, who has been accepted to Cleveland State University and will be pursuing his dream of becoming a film director. Lindsay Casey. Lindsay plans on becoming a public relations specialist and obtaining a communications degree from Hope College. Sid Casper will be attending BYU to study film. Isaac Gonzalez is going to attend Michigan State University and study graphic design or computer science. All right. Rebecca Corner is also going to attend BYU and has a declared major in music education. Jenny Cunningham is going to attend University of Michigan Flint to major in psychology with the goal of becoming a genetic counselor. With this odd scooting thing going on, I don't know how that happened, but it's okay. Kate Nightgorn intends to hone his guitar playing and make an album, and we've been discussing even this week, sort of getting into some music technology and some things like that. Not on the script. Sorry, I'm giving all the secrets away. Now Mom knows, I'm sorry. Tyler Fairman intends to attend Oakland University to major in cybersecurity. Nina Fernandez plans on pursuing a college degree in biology or psychology. At Grand Valley State University. Seth Goldstein plans to pursue a
degree.
Scary to that old. Plans to pursue a career in recording technology. Either at Specs Howard or Lawrence Tech. Shelby Good plans to attend the University of Texas, San Antonio to major in music education. Mel Grace plans on majoring in nursing at a four-year university. Saginaw Valley or Eastern Michigan. Samantha Harvey plans to attend University of Michigan to pursue either law or politics. Bryce Hendrickson will be going on a two-year mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, followed by enrollment at BYU Idaho to study mechanical engineering. Emily Horst plans to study civil engineering in German at a whole bunch of different places. She doesn't know yet. We had this conversation earlier this afternoon. There's like six different universities. Where were you accepted today? She was accepted at MSU today.
All right. Woo-hoo.
She also plans on being in the marching and concert bands wherever she does choose to attend school. Josie Jackson to
my left, your right, will be attending MSU to study law. While I'm here next to Josie, she's obviously not in uniform. She helps us out during the marching season, serving as sort of a jack of all trades throughout the course of that season. Serves as a librarian, grabs equipment, just kind of helps out during the day with our band, just kind of making everything roll when the drum majors aren't around or anything like that. So just a huge helping hand, just wherever she is. So thank you, Josie. Danny Jarrett. Attend school in Iceland after a gap year after graduation. Nice. Yeah. TJ Kimmel. Plans on pursuing a career as an apprentice plumber working towards being a master plumber. Kai Klink will attend Michigan State University to study physics. Physics. Faith Lillimoen plans on studying biochemistry with a career goal of becoming an obstetrician. A note here, and Dad Lillimoen, are you here tonight? She wasn't sure. Is he up there? Okay, so Faith got bumped off of the program for tonight in terms of the printed program. So I have two special printed programs that are corrected in there. If you want to pick that up for me at the end of the concert, my apologies. It is inadvertent and not intentional. Great, that's Faith Lillimoen here in County College. Martin Mann. Yeah. 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 Plans to double major in French horn performance and mechanical engineering.
University.
I had a brother-in-law that double majored in horn performance and chemical engineering. It's a lot, so good luck. Amy Mitten plans to attend Schoolcraft College and study graphic design. Corianna Mitchell will be attending Washtenaw Community College to pursue a degree in criminal justice. This is Isabel Money. She'll be back here with us again in the fall. Even as a senior, she had some health issues late last year, and so she has to catch up on academic work. So she'll be senioring with us again. Easy money. It was all on purpose, so she could be marching band again. Maxine McKeaton plans to study computer science at the University of Michigan. Is a foreign exchange student with us this year with the NIST. She plans to return to Japan for her last year of school and hopes to return to America after that to attend college and study education and psychology. Woo! Ben Paxton plans to attend Kettering University for mechanical engineering with a minor in acoustics. Tiger Page is planning a career in music. Does not know where yet. Isabel Passiola plans to attend Case Western Reserve University and get a bachelor's in chemical biology and pursue a career as a pharmacologist. She's far smarter than most of us. Samantha Peters hopes to attend the University of Michigan to study software engineering or computer science. Josie Phillips plans to attend Tulane University to study neuroscience. Madison Richardson will be working towards a degree in music education at Saginaw Valley State University.
Sarah Schutz hopes to attend Bowling Green State University to earn a degree in architecture or interior design. Ryan Schwander hopes to attend MSU to study biochemistry and continue to medical school to become a physician. Doing senior stuff this early in the year is weird because some of them don't know yet. Julia Sang, she will either be attending Kettering University to major in biochemistry or attending Wayne State University to major in the same thing, she hopes, and twirl with their marching band. Strider Toll is working to find the best path to create awesome video games. Aaron Bimmer will be studying dietetics at either Michigan State or Western Michigan University. Riley Orlewski will be attending a four-year university to study in the STEM field. It's not nowhere yet, it's somewhere. And Lauren Zavach will be attending Medina University to pursue a bachelor's degree in forensic science. But again, for our seniors.
I've waited 4 years to do this. So, who hasn't been thanked that, like, runs the program? Those guys! So we're gonna start with Anne Marie, because she's a sweetheart. We got you these wonderful flowers because you're so sweet and you do the color guard and that's hard. I can't catch a flag and run around on a field at the same time. That's why I stand with the men. Next is the wonderful Joe Gar. We know you like Culver's, so we got you a little Culver's-y something. obviously, the wonderful Mrs. Lively, who wrote the greatest show. She gets flowers. And the man, the myth, the legend,
Brad Lively.
So, our freshman year, we had these old uniforms that had capes. And he didn't like them, and we loved them. So we wrote our names on them and said the seniors. This idea was given by Strider. Where's Strider? Strider, he goes, we should write our names on a cape. And I was like, yes. So, on top of that, you also have a Culver's addiction. And we got you Culver's money. Merry Christmas. In all honesty, these people have, like, they raised us, pretty much. For a lot of us, this is our home. Like, I don't leave here until he leaves here, or Mrs. Helen Bosch leaves here, because I'm attached. And I don't know what you want to call them, like aunts and uncles, weird parents, but like, they hold a special place in our heart, and they have for the past 4 and 5 years, and we just love them so much, and it's sad to leave. But we're coming back. We're really not leaving. I'm coming back.
No, no.
Thanks, I hope you enjoy the show.
See what I have to deal with for 7 hours a day? Sometimes 14 hours a day? All right, two other groups of people. One, I want to thank our band booster board. Those folks tirelessly come to meetings and sometimes throw on the same ideas a lot just to get to whatever's the best for these guys that are behind me. They are invaluable for me as a sounding board. I will say that every concert that I'm able to thank them. They keep me from doing dumb things sometimes. Just as parents that, hey, is this going to work? And they're like, no, don't do that. I'm like, okay, that's, thank you. Which is awesome. And then obviously their support of kind of directing the finances of the band boosters and getting things to where they're most needed for those guys that are behind me. And then the last group, which is a group that works tirelessly, not because I ask them to, but because they want to document things that happen. So there's a whole slew of people that kind of operate as informal photographers for the group. Throughout the course of the season, with almost a steady stream of photos on the Facebook group and some other mediums that allow those of you that aren't able to be at a lot of our events to kind of see what's happening and highlight your student in that special way. So hopefully they've captured your student somewhere along the way. And if you've not seen those photographs, I would encourage you to follow us on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram to see some of those things and some of those moments that sometimes you might miss out if you're not with us all the time. So thank you, those people that take pictures. That is awesome. I can't do that myself. Thank you so very much. All right. I think we're going to move on with the show. Have you guys had enough rest?
No.
There's more to say?
Sophomore year. In 2016, Seattle-based hip-hop artist Macklemore penned a love letter to the moped. All you need is two wheels. We invite you to join us downtown.
Thank you.
Denver's top hits. Enjoy the vocal stylings of Country Roads. Join us in congratulating the class of 2019 on 4 fantastic years.
Thank you.
thanks.
And those are the people that you always see up in front of the band. I've been extraordinarily blessed over 5 years, really, to have our outstanding drum majors and folks that are able to see the things coming and do the things that are necessary before I even ask them to do it. And this year is no exception to that. These three people are not only fine drum majors and conductors and wonderful musicians, but they're great people. They're fun to work with, and none of this would really be possible without their work. And so there's nothing really else I can say other than thank you for being great people and being great representatives of our program, and good custodians of what we do as a group, and representatives of the public, because when somebody comes up for an interview on the football field or something like that, they're going to grab the person that's in the funny hat first and ask them to come in the picture. So these guys are awesome. I look forward to the rest of the year through our concert band continues leaning on them as just leaders in the group. So thank you so much.